Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. My name is Mohammed Fakhir, and today we are going to discuss what is Home Assistant and how can we install Home Assistant on Synology NAS. So, what is Home Assistant? Home Assistant is an open source home automation platform that allows user to control and automate various smart home devices. The best part is, unlike all other cloud providers, it focuses on privacy and the local control. Now, to me, the best part, the best feature of Home Assistant is the integrations. Thanks to all the official and community added integration, Home Assistant supports a vast array of smart devices, including lights, thermostats, cameras, sensors, and tons more. It's a basically unified interface for controlling and monitoring the smart home devices. You can then use all these devices into your automation to achieve a true smart home experience. So for the installation, there are multiple ways. We can use Home Assistant provided hardware, Home Assistant green, Home Assistant yellow, or you can use any other piece of hardware, any other PC, laptop, sitting around at your home, just to go and install Home Assistant on that one. But the method we are going to discuss today is using the virtual machine. We are going to download this .ova file from Home Assistant website, which we later then use into the virtual machine manager. So I'll share the link in the description below to download this file. Click on the link to download it, and then we'll jump onto this Synology virtual machine manager to install the. Okay, now let's jump onto the Synology NAS and look for Virtual Machine Manager. I will assume you have already installed Virtual Machine Manager on your Synology NAS and it's good to go. If you haven't done that already, go to Package Manager, find Virtual Machine Manager and install it from there. You will have to set it up. Just follow on-screen instructions and you should be good to go. Once it's ready, click create, click import, and then click next to import the OVA file. You can either browse it from your PC or you can just upload it to your NAS and browse it from there. For this tutorial, I've already uploaded it to my NAS, so I'll just browse it from there. Once you are given the path, just select next. It will bring up to your server which you just set it up. Just click next. On this page, you will have to set it up your virtual machine for the Home Assistant. So first, to start with, give it a meaningful name, which you can remember if you have multiple virtual machines running on your VMM. You can select CPU and the memory as per your requirement. For this tutorial, I'll leave them by default. You can select virtual machine priority, which will be given to your VM instance in case of high loads. Click next. For virtual disk size, leave it as default because this is coming from the virtual machine file we downloaded from Home Assistant. Click next. In network selection tab, I would leave it at default, but you can add a new network dedicated for the Home Assistant if you want. I'll leave it to default and click next. In this section, ignore first two settings, which are for the ISO files. We don't need any ISO file to boot up the Home Assistant. In Auto Start section, select Yes. This will automatically restart your Home Assistant in case your host machine shuts down. In the keyboard layout, I would leave it as default. Under USB section, select USB 3.0 in case you want to use any pass-through USBs on your Home Assistant. Click next. Select the users which can manage Home Assistant and click next. In the last page, review the summary and check power on virtual machine after the creation and click next. Virtual Machine Manager will take a while to create and power up the virtual machine. Once you see the IP addresses are assigned to the Home Assistant virtual machine, that means Home Assistant is almost loaded. You can click on Connect button from the Virtual Machine Manager to see the progress of the loading. Once you see the IP addresses are loaded and port numbers are displayed without any error, you can use this IP address and the port number to access Virtual Home Portal from the browser. When the portal is available, it may take 10 to 20 minutes for the Home Assistant to set itself up and get ready. You can click on Show Details to see the details of the process which are loading. Once the portal is ready, click on Create My Smart Home to add a new user. Give it a username and a password which you can remember, as this will be your admin for the Home Assistant. Once you have done that, click on Create Account. Next step is to set up your home location in a Home Assistant. This can be used in multiple home automations later. This can be changed later anytime. Last step, you can check if you want to share anonymous diagnostic information with the developers. Once you click Next, you'll see a list of smart devices which Home Assistant found under your network. Click on Finish button and it will take you to the first dashboard, which is the default dashboard of Home Assistant. Home Assistant is now fully installed and ready to go. You can tweak setting of your Home Assistant by going to the Setting tab. Here you can add more devices through the integrations. Just click on Devices and Add Integrations. I hope you liked today's video. Please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. We'll see you in the next video. Thank you very much.